When we say that Red Hat embraces open first, it's not just about words. It's about the power to choose without compromising security.
Hearing C-level executives within the government speak about their projects around open source, partners such as Microsoft and Emergent sharing what they are doing with open source, this is the preeminent show for anybody in government looking to build and use open source tools in their environment.
We have collaborators, competitors, all sort of putting aside their differences to align around an innovation mission. And that's happening at a scale that's unprecedented.
One of the benefits and sort of requirements of open source is that I make sure that my product's the very best to run these solutions and make sure that you choose us as your cloud provider because it's the best platform for you to run on, not because you feel like you have to.
Realized is that that cloud as a technology domain was far outpacing what we could do as the government in building these on-premise capabilities.
The biggest thing you can do to encourage innovation is to give people the permission to innovate.
And there's benefits to why open source, because with open source you can think about, I can give it to the community, they could find the bugs faster, I can respond to that, fix things, and we can share across government.
The government could really benefit from using open source to find security threats that are potentially out there, that are imminent, and research that ahead of time and possibly get in front of it by coding things into the applications that will prevent security threats from happening early on.
This is our 8th symposium, and it's been amazing to watch the symposiums grow from a very small number of government customers to over 600 folks here today.